What have been some of the challenges?
The biggest question that remains is how do we harness the hot temperature areas as we drill further down into the earth? The second challenge, which we have not been particularly good at, as you will see in the geothermal power plants in Iceland, is to build them more successfully into the landscape, to hide the pipes and so on and so forth, which is easy to do, but you just have to think it important in order to do it. If you compare geothermal with hydropower, the scale is completely different with respect to being environmentally friendly, because hydropower requires huge dams that can have an enormous impact on the landscape, whereas with geothermal, you basically drill a hole. And when you stop operating the plant in 70 years or 80 years' time, you just close the hole again and move the whole thing.
So what would cause you to ever move one of these facilities?
You might have to move to another area, because one of the things we have learned, and the Californians didn't know 50 years ago or so, is that you have to manage the boreholes. Some of them dry up. Some of them you can overutilize. You have to give some of them a time to recover until you start using them again. So you have to have a system where you move from one hole to another.